ACL estimates must consider past events, current conditions, and reasonable and supportable forecasts. Forecasts? How do I come up with a forecast of the future? Forecast of the future. I've got it. I'll travel into the future using a time machine. Then I'll know what information I need to use in today's estimate of future losses. Where am I? What year is it?
You're in Bedrock. It's the Stone Age. I'm Fred. Who are you?
I'm George. Nice to meet you. I think I ended up in the wrong time and place. I was trying to travel to the future, but it looks like something went wrong.
The future? Why do you need to go to the future? You look like you're already from the future.
Well, the Space Age is definitely more in the future than the Stone Age, but I wanted to go even further into the future. You see, I'm in a bit of a conundrum. I'm trying to estimate my credit losses for the period end, and the accounting guidance tells me I need to come up with reasonable and supportable forecasts of future losses to support my estimate of expected credit losses. But apparently using a time machine isn't the answer.
Oh, George, you don't need a fancy time machine to apply the CECL model. Sit down. Let me explain how I estimate credit losses on the financial receivables that my rock quarry is outstanding each quarter.
How can someone who still powers their car with their feet estimate credit losses and come up with a forecast of the future?
Well, I may be from the Stone Age, but even I can make forecasts of the future. I'll let you in on a little secret to get you started. History often repeats itself. You see, I can't just rely on historical information when I estimate my expected credit losses for the rock quarry, because the losses I've experienced in the past likely do not exactly represent the assets I have in my portfolio today, so I make adjustments. Then I think about what's going on around here and make even more adjustments. Lastly, I incorporate forecasts of what I think will occur in the future into my estimate.
Yeah, but you don't have a time machine, so how do you know what's going to happen in the future?
You're right. I don't have a time machine, but I can use the information I do know to make reasonable and supportable forecasts. And then the guidance lets me revert to use the historical loss data for any remaining periods of the asset's contractual term that I can't make a reasonable and supportable forecast for.
Well, maybe I don't need this time machine after all.
Don't ditch your fancy time machine so fast, George. You're taking me on a visit to the future. I want to give my feet a break and try out a flying car. Meet a robot too?
In this module, we'll cover the concepts of the current expected credit loss model for financial instruments under U.S. GAAP to help George understand how to estimate credit losses without using a time machine. We'll discuss what the CECL model is, the instruments subject to the guidance, recognition, subsequent measurement, key aspects of a credit loss estimate, and required disclosures. Additionally, we'll discuss the accounting for purchased credit deteriorated assets and certain beneficial interests.